le pont Mirabeau. Sur le pont Mirabeau coule la Seine et nos amours. Faut dire qu'ils m'en souviennent, la joie venait toujours après la peine. Vient la nuit, sonne l'heure, les jours s'en vont, je demeure. Les mains dans les mains, restant face à face, tandis que sous le pont de nos bras passe, des éternels regardent l'ancilas. Vient la nuit, sonne l'heure, les jours s'en vont, je demeure. L'amour s'en va comme cette eau courante, l'amour s'en va comme la vie est lente, et comme l'espérance est violente, vienne la nuit, sonne l'heure, les jours s'en vont, je demeure. Passent les jours et passent les semaines, ni temps passé, ni les amours reviennent. Sous le pont Mirabeau coule la Seine, vienne la nuit comme l'heure, les jours s'en vont, je demeure.
Under the Mirabeau bridge flows the Seine, and must it remind me of our love? Joy has always come after sorrow. Let the night come and the bells toll the hour, the days slip away, and yet here I am. Hand in hand, let us stand fixed on each other's eyes, while under the bridge of our arms passes the unhurried current of endless gazes. Let the night come and the bell toll the hour. The days slip away, yet here I am. Love slips away, just like this water runs to the sea. Love slips away. How slow life is, and how violent is hope. Let the night come and the bells toll the hour. The days slip away, and yet here I am. The days pass by and the weeks pass. Neither time's gone by nor love's come back again. Under the Mirabeau bridge flows the Seine. Let the night come and the bell toll the hour. The days slip away, yet here I am.
Demain, dès l'aube, Victor Hugo. Demain, dès l'aube, à l'heure où blanchit la campagne, je partirai. Vois-tu, tu sais que tu m'attends. J'irai par la forêt, j'irai par la montagne. Je ne puis demeurer loin de toi plus longtemps. Je marcherai les yeux fixés sur mes pensées, sans rien voir autour, sans entendre aucun bruit, seul, inconnu, le dos courbé, les mains croisées, triste, et le jour pour moi sera comme la nuit. Je ne regarderai ni l'or du soir qui tombe, ni les voiles au loin descendant vers la fleur. Et quand j'arriverai, je mettrai sur la tombe un bouquet de houx verts et de bruyères en fleurs.
Tomorrow, at dawn, at the hour when the countryside turns white, I will set out. You see, I know you're waiting for me. I'll go through the forest. I'll go over the mountain. I cannot stay away from you any longer. I will walk, my eyes fixed on my thoughts, seeing nothing outside nor hearing any noise. Alone, unknown, backbent, hands crossed, sad. And the day will be like night for me. I will not look at the golden glow of the falling evening, nor the distant sails going down towards A Fleur. And when I arrive, I will put on your tomb a bouquet of green holly and blooming heather.
G'day, folks. My first order is to take off my mask, as I'm, I believe, permitted to do because I'm going to be talking to you and singing to you. Welcome to the concert that the Boite has very kindly arranged for us, La Mauvaise Reputation, to play for you in this midst of lockdown here in Melbourne. My name's Paul. We have Salvatore on accordion and Enzo on double bass. They will be singing backing vocals through their masks today, so it will be a particular technical challenge that these guys are perfectly set up to do. We must give apologies for our colleague John, who's unable to make it today because of his health, which is he's much missed for today's performance. The first song I'd like to do is really a response to the two poems that you've heard to begin this performance. The first poem was a poem by Guillaume Apollinaire called Le Pont Mirabeau, which is one of the bridges over the Seine. And the second poem is a poem by Victor Hugo from the 19th century. And it's a poem about walking to visit the grave of his daughter. And her, there is also a link to the Seine and to the river in this second poem, because his daughter died at the young age of 19 when she fell out of a boat in the Seine and drowned. And it was a great tragedy for not only Hugo, but the nation itself. It made the news. And Hugo wrote that second poem about his daughter and her grave. So the first song we'd like to perform to you is a song that I'll do solo. It's a tune written by Serge Gainsbourg, probably my favorite French songwriter. And it's a poem called La Noyée, which I really think has a lot of echoes of Baudelaire. It's a dark poem, a sad poem, a melancholic poem, and certainly the first two poems are fairly melancholic. It's a poem, in fact, about a drowned girl. So I thought in response to really the images of the Seine and also the second poem from Hugo that it was an appropriate start to our set. Now, I warn you, we're in deep melancholy here, and the French do melancholy better than almost anybody. But don't worry, we've got two sets, and we're going to craft you a little journey from melancholy through to joy. So we're packing all of our sad songs into the first one to match the rather somber tone of the poems that we're performing with, and then we're going to bring it up for some fun during the second set, just to prove that we can get through melancholy together, folks. So I'm going to start with this most beautiful tune by Serge Gainsbourg. It's a tune that he never actually put on an album, so it's a bit of a lost classic.
Tout t'en va à la dérive sur la rivière de souvenirs. Sur la rive, je te crie de revenir, mais lentement tu t'éloignes. Chienne crevée au fil mais je reste ton esclave.
Thanks very much. Now, let me introduce my colleagues, Salvatore Greco on the accordion and Enzo Rubarto on double bass. I'm going to extract my guitar pick from the folds of my mask. And we've programmed another Serge Gainsbourg tune. This is a song about a song. It's a tune called La Chanson de Prévert. And the Chanson de Prévert is a song written by Jacques Prévert called Les Feuilles Mortes, one of the most famous ballads, and in English, Autumn Leaves, it's known as, and it's of course one of the most well-known jazz standards. So this is a very meta-textual work from Serge Gainsbourg, referring back to another song and exploring the elements of that song in its own lyrics. Ultimately, it's also a song about loss, just as the previous one was, and just as our first two poems were. After this song, we're going to go into the song that it is talking about. So you're going to hear La Chanson de Prévert, the song by Gainsbourg, and then you're going to hear the actual song of Prévert called Les Feuilles Mortes. Gentlemen.
Je voudrais tant que tu te souviennes cette chanson était la tienne. C'était ta préférée, je crois. Elle est le Prévert et Cosma. Bien sûr, je m'abandonne, mais la chanson est monotone. Et peu à peu, je m'en défais. À cela, il n'y a rien à faire. Qu'à chaque de mourir. Thank you. peut-on jamais savoir par où commence? Chanson de l'hiver. Cette chanson, les feuilles remontent, se fasse de mon souvenir. Et ce jour-là,
so good to play again, guys. It's been so long. Wow. Yeah. Thanks for having us, Boite fans. It's lovely. It's lovely to be playing again. Wow. Now, we're going to play for you now the song that that previous song was written about. So that previous song written by Serge Gainsbourg in the late 60s was referring to this song written by Jacques Prévert, well-known poet, and Joseph Cosma in about 1945. Originally written for a ballet called Le Rendezvous, it was first performed as a standalone pop song by Yves Montand and Cora Vauquer. They both recorded it within about 6 months of each other in about 1949.
Oh, je voudrais tant que tu te souviennes des jours heureux où nous étions amis. En ces temps-là, la vie était plus belle et le soleil plus brûlant qu'aujourd'hui. Les feuilles mortes se ramassent de la pelle. Tu vois, je n'ai pas oublié. Les feuilles mortes se ramassent de la pelle. Les souvenirs et les regrets aussi. Et le vent du nord les emporte dans la nuit froide de l'oubli. Tu vois, je n'ai pas oublié la chanson que tu m'as chantée. C'est une chanson qui nous ressemble. Toi, tu m'aimais et je t'aimais. Et nous vivions à deux ensemble. Toi qui m'aimais, moi qui t'aimais. Mais la vie sépare ceux qui s'aiment. Tout doucement, sans faire de bruit. Et la mer efface sur le sable. Thank you. window, the falling leaves of red and brown. I see your lips, the summer kisses, the sunburnt hands I used to hold since you went away. The days grow long, and soon I'll hear old winter song. But I miss you most of all, my darling.
Gee, we've got a lot of Serge Gainsbourg in the first set. I decided to go melancholy in the first set to match the poetry choices, and of course that means we're almost exclusively Serge Gainsbourg. This next song is called La Javanaise, one of his most celebrated songs. There's a lot of complexity to these lyrics that don't survive translation. It's really worth trying to find a parallel translation of this tune. It's essentially a love song, but it plays with sounds in a way that mimics a type of sort of pig Latin called Javanaise that has been a popular French argot for a long time. That was recorded in 1963 by Gillett Greco, and the same year by Serge Gainsbourg.
J'avoue, je n'ai bavé pas vous, mon amour, avant de voir devant de vous, mon amour. Ne vous déplaise, en dansant la javanaise, nous aimions le temps d'une chanson. À votre avis, que vaut-nous de l'amour? De vous et moi, vous m'avez dit, mon amour. Ne vous déplaise, en dansant la javanaise, nous aimions le temps. Vous à l'amour, je vais envie de voir en vous cet amour. Ne vous déplaise, en dansant la javanaise, nous aimions le chant. La vie ne vaut d'être vécue sans amour. mais c'est vous qui l'avez voulu, mon amour. Ne vous déplaise, en dansant la javanaise, nous aimions le temps d'une
Javanese by Serge Gainsbourg from 1963, and if it sounds like a song you'd like to dance to, it's because it is a song about dancing. We loved, but for the space of just one song, is the chorus there. Whilst we danced, let's dance the Javanese, which is this sort of imaginary dance that Serge has conjured up. Now we're going to do one more song for you, and then throw over to Poets' Corner for some more poesie. This last tune certainly is worthy of inclusion in the canon of French poetry, let alone songwriting. It's one of the most famous songs by one of the most famous French songwriters that ever lived, famous for performing not only in French but in English, Spanish. He was originally Armenian by birth, and we lost him. He sang in Italian as well. Wow. So, extraordinary guy. Of course, we're talking about Charles Aznavour, who was really beloved throughout Europe then. And throughout the world. This is, again, maybe a melancholic song, but with a sweet tinge. Aznavour would always, I think, leaven the melancholy in a way that Serge didn't. So this is a song about remembering sweeter and happier times when we were young and free. But there's a gentle, wistful pleasure in the recollection. Take it away, Sal.
Parle d'un temps que les moins de 20 ans ne peuvent pas connaître. Mon matin, ce temps-là, accroché ces lilas jusque sous nos fenêtres. Et si l'humble garni qui nous servait de nid ne payait pas de mine, c'est là qu'on sait que nous, moi qui criais famine, et toi qui posez-nous. La bohème, la bohème, ça voulait dire on est heureux. La bohème, nous ne mangeons qu'un jour sur deux. Dans le café voisin, nous étions quelques-uns qui attendions la gloire, et bien que miséreux, avec le ventre creux, nous ne cessions d'y croire. Et quand quelques bistrots, contre un bon repas chaud, nous prenaient une toile, nous récitions des vœux, groupés à tout du poil, en oubliant l'hiver. La bohème, la bohème, ça voulait dire tout est joli. La bohème, et nous avions tous deux génies. Souvent il m'arrivait devant mon chevalet de passer des nuits blanches pour toucher le dessin de la guilbe d'un de scène. Et c'est qu'au matin, quand ça s'est enfin devant un café crème, épuisé mais ravie, on s'aime et qu'on aime la vie. La bohème, ça voulait dire on a 20 ans. La bohème, et nous vivions de l'air du temps.
Salvatore!
Des jours, je m'en vais faire un tour en mon ancienne adresse. Je ne reconnais plus ni les murs ni les rues qui ont vu ma jeunesse. En haut d'un escalier, je cherche l'atelier dont plus rien ne subsiste. Dans son nouveau décor, mon maître semble triste. Elle est là, son mot. La bohème, ça voulait dire on est heureux. La bohème, nous ne mangeons qu'un jour sur deux. Oh la bohème, on était jeunes, on était fous. La bohème, ça ne veut plus rien dire du tout.
La bohème, by Charles Aznavour. Leading us into another Poet's Corner. So I'm going to put my mask back on and sit back and enjoy a couple of readings, and then we'll see you again very shortly.
Ode à Cassandre Pierre de Rosa. Mignonne, allons voir si la rose qui ce matin avait déclose sa robe de pourpre au soleil. À point perdu cette vesprée, les plis de sa robe pourpre et son teint au vôtre pareil. Las, voyez comme un peu d'espace, mignonne est là-dessus la place. Las, las ses beautés laissent choir. Oh vraiment marâtre nature, puisqu'une telle fleur ne dure que du matin jusqu'au soir. Donc, si vous me croyez mignonne, tandis que votre âge fleuronne en sa plus verte nouveauté, cueillez, cueillez votre jeunesse comme à cette fleur la vieillesse fera tenir votre beauté.
My sweet, come, let us see if the rose which this morning opened her crimson dress to the sun has lost this evening the soft folds of that crimson dress, and her colour, which is so like your own. Alas, see how in such a short time, my sweet, she has let her beauty fall away. Oh, truly cruel nature, when such a flower only lasts from morning until evening. So, if you trust me, my sweet, while your youth is blooming in greenest freshness, enjoy, enjoy your youth, because just as with this faded flower, age will tarnish your beauty.
Les roses de Sadi, J'ai voulu ce matin te rapporter des roses, mais j'en avais tant pris dans mes ceintures closes que les nœuds trop serrés n'ont pu les contenir. Les nœuds ont éclaté, les roses ont volé dans le vent, à la mer sont toutes allées, elles ont suivi l'eau pour ne plus revenir. La vague en a paru rouge et comme enflammée. Ce soir, ma robe encore en est tout embonnée. Respire-en sur moi l'odorant souvenir.
I wanted to bring you roses this morning, but I'd taken so many of them into my corset's laces that the tight knots couldn't contain them. The knots burst apart. The roses, carried away on the wind, have all gone to the sea. They followed the water, never to return. And the waves turned red, as if they were ablaze. This evening, my dress is still drenched in their scent. On my breast, you can breathe in that fragrant memory. So, Les Roses de Sardi appeared in a posthumous book of Marcelin de Bourg-Vallon's writing in 1860. But this poem also appears in a collection of Andrew Lang's poems. He was born in 1844, so if he were to have written it in 1860, he would have been a very young man to have written this, and yet it's listed as his work. This morning I vowed I would bring thee my roses. They were thrust in the band that my bodice encloses, but the breast knots were broken and the roses went free. The breast knots were broken. The roses together floated forth on the wings of the wind and the weather, and they drifted afar down the streams of the sea. And the sea was as red as when sunset uncloses. But my raiment is sweet from the scent of the roses. Thou shalt know, love, how fragrant a memory can be.
So, folks, welcome back to our little French chanson corner. You've come from Poets' Corner. I now get to take off my mask again, according to regulations. We have heard two poems with a very obvious theme of roses. The first by Pierre de Ronsard, which dates back to the 16th century, just a classic ode to beauty and youth. Following that, I think it's an early 19th century poem about the gathering of roses. And by the way, if you've ever seen a rose called Pierre de Ronsard, that is a rose that's named after the poet who wrote that first poem because of that first poem. There's really only one song, if you're thinking of rose-themed chanson, there's really only one song that can follow those two poems. So we're going to do that for you now, after I take a brief sip of water. This is a song by the most famous of all French singers of the 20th century, and it was the song that changed this woman from a national star to an international superstar.
Des yeux qui font baisser les miens, en rire qui s'aperce sous sa bouche, voilà le portrait sans retouche de l'homme auquel j'appartiens. Quand il me prend dans ses bras, qu'il me parle tout bas, je vois la vie en rose. Il me dit des mots d'amour, des mots de tous les jours, et ça me fait quelque chose. Il est entré dans mon cœur une part de bonheur dont je connais la cause. C'est lui. lui pour moi, moi pour lui dans la vie. Il me l'a dit la journée pour la vie. Alors je sens en moi mon cœur qui bat. Chagrin trépasse, heureux, heureux, à en mourir. Quand il me prend dans ses bras, qu'il me parle tout bas, je vois la vie en rose. Ça me fait quelque chose. Il est entré dans mon cœur. On n'est pas de bonheur dont je connais la cause. C'est toi pour moi, moi pour toi dans. La journée pour la vie. Dès que je l'aperçois, alors je sens en moi mon.
Thanks very much, folks. We're going to take a short break and come back with a second set. See you soon.
Thank you.